today we're doing the baking soda and vinegar science experiment.
Kids overseas. Versus kids in Australia.
I'm doing science.
Okay, you're going to do a science experiment?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep, new research has found Aussie students are falling behind when it comes to science. The report measures our school science education against seven others around the world, including England, Singapore and the US. Aussie students learning about half as much with an average of 44 science topics under their belts by the time they've finished 9 years of school, compared to 74 topics overseas. Of those, only five are covered in depth, compared to 22 in other countries.
There's simply no way that you can have a curriculum that in the first 9 years of schooling has half the content. That's just robbing Australian students of a quality curriculum.
The news that we've got at the moment is highly concerning for us. A lot of people underestimate the role of being able to be a scientific thinker, whether it's measuring the petrol tank, whether it's making choices about our nutrition and the contribution that we're making to the environment.
Since our national curriculum was introduced in 2010, our science results have tanked. Experts now calling for a complete overhaul.
If we don't address this problem comprehensively, we're not going to have people like doctors, people like researchers. We're not going to be seen as leaders. We're not going to be seen as making our contribution to some of the world's big problems, because a lot of those problems have scientific answers.
I made a mess on purpose.
Love that as an excuse. Dr. Kat Ross is an astrophysicist and is one of those pushing for an overhaul of our science curriculum. Dr. Ross, what do you think the biggest mistakes are in the way that we teach science?
I think at the moment we're teaching science the same way that we always have, and we've just been continuing on the same path of teaching science the way that we discovered it, discovery after discovery of, you know, a lone scientist sitting in a basement by themselves working away. That's not what science is. It's not what science ever was.
Dr. Kat, science was never my strong suit. I never even got my Bunsen burner licence in year seven. I failed that.
I'm stunned.
I used a cigarette lighter and blew up the K-block. Anyway, but can you explain the importance of studying science, even for people if they're not even thinking about using it in their career? Why should they be studying it?
Look, you may not have gotten your Bunsen burner licence, but using a lighter, that's innovation.
That's innovation right there. That's not
so
what
a really
my principal
good
job. Said, but they suspended me for 3 days.
I think having this science and being science literate is so important, not just in school and not just for becoming a scientist and maybe being a researcher, but having science literacy in your day-to-day life is really fundamental. From things like understanding what drugs you should be purchasing for certain things, we're facing a real issue with antibiotic resistance because of people constantly seeking antibiotics for issues that really don't need them. Even things of safety in your car, how you should be driving, understanding the forces behind those cars. There is just so many examples of the role that science plays in everyday life that if you're not science literate and if you're really struggling with those concepts, that can impact you in ways you may not even understand.
So if we're not science literate, what is this going to mean then for the future of Australia's research, our doctors, medical breakthroughs?
I think we're already facing some of this issue at the moment. Australia is facing a really critical STEM skills shortage, STEM, science, technology, engineering and maths. A lot of scientists and engineers particularly, we just don't have enough of them here in Australia. And there's another big issue of all the people we are training up in these areas are then leaving Australia to do that elsewhere. So we're facing this shortage at a time where it's incredibly critical to be not just maintaining this workforce, but growing it and expanding it, particularly if we want to be seen as an international powerhouse in science.
Yeah, I wonder if there's a sense of, as long as someone's doing it, it doesn't have to be me. Maybe we saw that attitude during the pandemic, actually, you know, where these epidemiologists sort of appeared out of nowhere and they seemed to know what was happening and that explained things to us. Take a situation like that for just the general population to have a level of science literacy when even listening to experts.
We had these scientists coming out, as you said, that just sort of appeared out of nowhere that seemed really to know what was going on and have a lot of information. They were kind of these rock stars of the pandemic, which was amazing to see as a scientist. But what really got Australia through was the community and this understanding of the role that masks had and the infection and spread rate of COVID. And that comes from having a population that's science literate. And that's really what we need in a science education system. We need to be building that science literacy and building that sense of community and trust in science as well.
Dr. Kat, if you were my science teacher, I may have stuck with it. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much.